Hello everyone, it's John, W5CYF. In this video, I've got a little inexpensive, easy to build project that allows you to switch when you're using Morse code between a paddle and a key very easily. The radio that I use is an ICOM 7200 that I really like a lot. The 7200, like many mid-range or entry-level radios, only has one input for a key on the back. Now, the radio, like many do today, is equipped to run a straight key, a bug, or a paddle. But with only one input in it, I have to reach all the way around the back of the radio to plug in the key. Now, I have made an extension that I just made a little box to come around to the front of the radio, but I still have to unplug and do lots of other different things to change from straight key to paddle. The reason I do that is because I joined several years ago the SKCC Club, which is Straight Key Century Club. If you're not a member, I do encourage you to look into that. It's a lot of fun. It's got great people in it. And what we do, we swap our member number, and we use a straight key to do that. Well, sometimes I'm on a paddle, and I want to be on the up and up, and I want to switch over to a straight key so that I can send my number and have a very brief QSO. So this project is inexpensive. It's really easy to build. If you've not built anything before, it's a real good project. It's very useful. And follow along, and I'll show you how to build this thing. It takes about an hour to build. The materials needed for this project are not great and are not expensive. You'll need a small project box. This is the little small Radio Shack project box. If you've seen my videos before where I use these project boxes, you may recall that I just use masking tape so that I can mark on the box where I'm going to drill my holes and so forth. So you'll need a little small project box like that. You're going to need a plug, a quarter-inch stereo plug, or if your radio uses the eighth-inch, this would be where your eighth-inch stereo, or I believe it's also known as a 3.5-millimeter plug, that you'll have back through there. But both my radios, my little ICOM 703 and my 7200, use a quarter-inch, so make sure that you have a stereo plug on it. You'll also need a couple of jacks. Now, on this distribution box, if you use a rotary switch, you can just wire it up. I'll show you the wiring part here in just a few moments. But for me, I just want one that I can use for paddles and another one that I can use for straight keys. If I need to switch paddle or straight key, I can just plug it in. I don't have a whole lot of paddles or straight keys, and usually I just leave them dedicated to an individual radio. But what I want to do here is have the paddle and the straight key hooked up to my station here at the house, and that way I don't have to reach around the back and do a bunch of plug changing and so forth. I can just switch back and forth. And so you'll need the plug, you'll need two stereo jacks, and you're going to need a double pole double throw switch. Now, I had this one on hand. This one is actually a center off, so I think I'm going to like that better. But if you don't have a center off, you can just do the same thing by double pole, double throw. But this one is off in the center, and I got that at Radio Shack, one of those little going out of sale Radio Shack switches, so I was able to get it. So I'll put this aside, and I'll go through the, I call it a drawmatic. It's part drawing and part schematic. But this is the way it'll be drawn out. As you know, the plug, all stereo plugs have what's known as tip, ring, and sleeve. The far end is your tip, the one in the middle is your sleeve, and the one up here is your, the tip, ring, and sleeve. The tip is here, this is your ring. It's the one that's split apart by the two insulators, and a tip, ring, and shield. This is your shield, that's your ground right there. So that's how it's going to be wired up from the plug. So I'll take the tip and I run it right in here. This is the switch part right here that I've got drawn. So it'll go to the center of the switch, the tip and the ring. The sleeve will be grounded. Now the sleeve it's going to be a third wire ground, but just for drawing in here, I'm just using the ground symbol here. So the tip goes to the center, the ring goes to the center, and then off to one side of the switch, I'm going to pull the other tip and the other ring, and of course the sleeve will be grounded down here. Same thing over here. If I throw the switch over to this side, I'm just going to be running my tip goes out and my ring goes out to this one right here, and the sleeve is grounded. Now I'm going to be using a 3-wire that'll be coming in to the switch, and it's just a regular paddle switch that you can use, or a regular paddle wire that you can use. If you don't have 3 wires, you can use speaker wire and just run a 3rd wire for your ground. So pretty simple to draw up, pretty simple to wire up. I'm going to go ahead and build the switch, and then I'll come back and I'll show you how it works. Before I go and do the wiring, just when you build stuff, you're going to build it according to what fits you the best. And there's a couple of ways that this could be done. You could have your jacks on this side, and if you want to have them out that side, you can put the switch on this side over here. You can put the jacks up front, put your switch in the middle. You can put the jacks on both sides, switch in the middle, and so forth. For me, I'm going to have my jacks on one side like that, and the switch will be on the other side. And the reason that I'm doing it this way is when I have it on my bench, I want the plugs and everything going towards the back of the radio. If I need, and then I can just switch from one to the other by using the front side of my project box. So inside, that's what it's going to be. But you can just as easily, put them up like that if you wanted to. There's just all kind of different variations that you might choose to do. But give it some thought before you do it. Of course, this way right here, if you do it, you're going to have your plugs in the way of your switch. You could also do it and put the switch on the end like that if you chose to. So, and then, you turn it up on the end and let it go however which way you want to go with it. So just give it a little bit of thought before you start drilling holes. And if you do, the worst thing that happens is you just use that project box for something else and start over again. Okay, the workbench is pretty full right now, but I'll show you what I've got going here. Let's see if I can get it all in focus here. I've got a J38 key, and I've got a paddle over here. So this is what the intent is. Now I've got it going into an oscillator. So I've got that. Of course, the center's off. Nothing happens now. So when I come over all the way over to here, got that. Switch back over to paddle. Now it's just a matter of hooking that up. Put the lid on it, and the back of it's coming out like that. Got your place for the wire. So all I'll be doing is having the front end of it facing me with the switch on it. That's how everything works. Well, here's the switch, and I have attached it over here to the edge of the box, and I just have it, the switch that I put in is a double pull, double throw with off in the center. You don't necessarily need the off in the center, but I just happen to have that on hand, so that's what I used. So when I'm switching, I can just switch between the two just by flipping the switch. So all I have to do then is just come over here and then change the settings on the 7200, or if you have a different radio, you can just go in and change it from your key to your paddle to your bug and so forth. Now here I just have key and paddle listed. Also, I'm not very good at a bug, and I don't use it on the air very much, but it sure is a lot of fun to play with here with a little keyer. But if I need to use a bug, I'll just plug it in the back of here. So everything is real easy to get to. So real good project, very, very easy to use, and it's easy. I just drilled two screws in it to attach to the bottom. Now if I could just figure out what that was right there, just figure out what that MIC stands for. I don't know. This thing's a real good Morse code CW radio. Don't know what that would be on there for. Anyway, this is John, W5CYF. We'll catch you on there. CW, of course.